Hi guys, in this video I'm going to cover how to activate, register, set up and update the D7 XTool scanner. This is currently one of the best bidirectional tools on the market at this price point. Now let's get this. I'm doing this live for the first time, so you're going to see exactly what the experience is like. Let me just power on the scanner. While that comes on, I had done an earlier video where I reviewed this bidirectional scanner for under $500, which I think is a great deal. Usually starts with all this animation. First thing you're going to do is to select the language. English is already selected. I'll just click on next. Dear customer, greetings. Thank you for using our product. The product needs to be activated over the internet. If not, you can also click trial. If you just want to demo around, you can click that. I'll just click on start activate. You're going to need Wi-Fi, of course. Enter my Wi-Fi password and then click OK. Sorry for the glare. I'm connected to the internet. Time to activate. Accept the terms. Okay, so and that's it. Activation is done, or registration is done. Now the next thing is that, so it begins to initialize the data or setting up the scanner. That took about 5 minutes and you're done. The next thing you're advised to do, is to update the scanner right after activation. If not, it's going to be blank. Do you want to install an update to this existing application? Your existing data will not be lost. Yeah. The diagnosis app, that's the XTool app, is installed. Let's go back to the XTool app. Okay, so we go to updates.
You don't really need to download all these updates, especially for cars you know you don't work on or would never work on. As you can see, quite a number of pending manufacturer updates, 83 in total. Before I go ahead to demo the update process itself, let me run through the details of some of these pending updates. On the Citroen, some good amount of updates, I won't go into details. For the Lexus, some optimization as well as bug fixes. Good to see updates for 2022 already rolling out for some cars. That's usually an indication of commitment to release updates as new models are launched. Also, with the 3-year free update from XTool and only $99 per year after your subscription expires, this tool is proving to be a really good investment and value delivered to end users. Audi, basic functions supported until 2022, including version information, code reading, clearing, data flow, matching, advanced recognition, and so on and so forth. Also adds those new models like the 2022 A7, the e-tron, etc. I don't really see an order to the arrangement of these updates. Not really an issue, but it just means you have to scroll around before you find what you're looking for. XTool, perhaps you can arrange this in alphabetical order. For instrument cluster special function, adds repairing of the 2015 Ford Raptor instrument mileage. Not sure if this means mileage correction. Perhaps I'll follow up with XTool support. For the American market, Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, Ford optimizes the throttle matching process. For Toyota, a more detailed update fixed the problem of ABS bleeding failure of the 1999 Toyota Land Cruiser. It's good to see that XTool is going as far back as 1999 to fix bugs. Some scan tools just forget about older cars and focus on newer cars. We also see bug fixes to the 2019 Lexus as well as the 2004 Harrier, again going back to fix issues with older cars. And then some active test updates for some 2017 and above Toyotas. So many updates, but I'll just go ahead to update the Honda since I'm in a Honda.
So the Honda stats, or the Acura rather. So Honda is updating 100%.
There were also some Android style updates that occurred while I was using the tool indoors. This was more of an Android OS update. In all, it's good to see XTool's commitment to both older and newer cars via updates. As always, if you're considering the D7, be sure to check that the functions and brands that you usually work on are well supported.
Hope this was helpful. Catch you on the next one. Peace.